You're listening to Leaders Last. Leaders Last. With your host, Dr. David Robertson.
All right. Welcome back to another edition of Leaders Last, where we talk about all things leadership. I'm your host, Dr. David Robertson. Thank you so much for being a part of the program. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about how to develop a personal brand as a leader. In a lot of ways, this is a crucial topic because a strong personal brand can help you stand out in your industry and make a lasting impact. So let's get started. What exactly is a personal brand? Well, simply put, it's how you present yourself to the world. It's your values, your strengths, and your unique qualities. You know, as a leader, your personal brand can influence your team, your peers, your industry, random strangers. Another way to think of it, it's like your logo. Now, in some cases, it might actually include a logo. For example, in my area, I'm often associated with the logo of my private practice. Of course, I try really hard to ensure that that logo is associated with excellence, which means that I have to deliver excellence with my services. Now, developing a personal brand is not about being fake or pretending to be someone you're not. It's really important to be authentic. Do what you say you're going to do. Strive for excellence at all times, if that's what you're trying to portray. Either way, it's really important to be authentic. Of course, whether you've been in the game for a long time or you're just getting started, remember that your personal brand is about highlighting your strengths and values in a way that resonates with others. However, I would also argue that it's about not lying or trying to hide your shortcomings or weaknesses. You don't have to be the smartest person in the room, and you don't have to pretend to be some highly successful leader if you're not. As I've often said, Urubu, you are you, be you. All right, so let's dive into some tips on how to develop your personal brand as a leader. Tip number one, identify your strengths and values. Take some time to reflect on what makes you unique as an individual and a leader. What are your key strengths and values? Now, this exercise can be a little difficult, but it's important to have a clear understanding of your personal brand before you can start building it. In other words, you need to know you, the true you. Tip number two, build your online presence. In today's digital age, having a strong online presence is essential. Create a professional website or blog, and make sure your social media profiles align with your personal brand. And once you've built that, share your thoughts and ideas with your audience. This is a great way to establish yourself as a thought leader in your industry. In all truth, I have several online personas for the different worlds I find myself in. And this includes leadership, three actually on that front, but also health, philosophy, and so on. It doesn't have to just be one, and it doesn't all have to be coordinated in some massive marketing effort. Tip three, be authentic. Your personal brand should be a reflection of who you are. Don't try to be someone you're not. People can see through inauthenticity. Be honest, transparent, and genuine in your interactions with others. And this is actually a really big problem on social media, partially due to the Dunning-Kruger effect. Now, I've talked about this before, but if you're not an expert, don't pose as one. If you think you are, then you probably need to look into what expertise truly entails. Then, after you learn that truth, revise your brand accordingly. If you happen to be an actual expert, congratulations. But that's not going to be most people. You can be highly proficient, and that's okay to profess, but there's just not a lot of experts in a lot of things, and that's okay. You'll get there eventually. Tip number four, and this one's often overlooked and I would say underappreciated. You gotta build a strong network. Networking is the key to building your personal brand. It's also key to building your business or making professional connections. So attend industry events, connect with other leaders in your field, and collaborate on projects. The more you connect with others, the more opportunities you'll have to showcase your brand. The more of those opportunities that present themselves, the more opportunities you are going to have in your career. Tip number five, learn, and then learn some more. Remember, knowledge is power. And when you can become the person that people will turn to for the answers and you can provide non-biased and accurate answers, you're going to see victory. But that's the key. That's the hiccup, though. You have to be knowledgeable. And you know what? Even if people don't agree with you, and even if they don't like you, they will respect you if you are coming to the table with accuracy. Now, building a personal brand takes time and effort, but it's worth it. Now, I haven't covered all the tips, but these are tips that'll definitely get you started. Not only will these tips help you stand out in your industry, but it'll also help you attract new opportunities to build credibility with your team and colleagues, and like I said before, total strangers. So there you have it. Those are some tips on how to develop your personal brand as a leader. Remember, your personal brand is a reflection of who you are as a leader. So take the time to reflect on your strengths and values, and then build some online presence, be authentic, and build a strong network. Thanks for listening to Leaders Last. We'll see you next time. Take care.